The next fourth element of directing, that is communication. So as you know, there are mainly four elements of directing. One is supervision, second is leadership, then third is motivation. So you know about all these three elements. Then fourth element of directing, that is communication. So the communication plays a vital role in each and every organization, in common also. So without communication, somewhat it is very difficult to imagine how the world is. So just do imagine, without communication, how the world can be. So therefore, if I want to convey any information to you, if I want to give any knowledge regarding about a subject to you, means I must use the communication in understanding language to the sender and receiver. If I am speaking in some other language, if you could not understand that language, means there is no use of exchanging of ideas. So as a manager, you are guiding the employee, means you must use the proper communication technique. So you must identify in which language they understood. In that language, you must convey the information and you must guide an employee. So therefore, communication is a basic factor in the organization. So like for a human body, how the heart is important, like that for a organization, communication is important to that. So because it spreads the information to all over an organization, to entire the corners of the organization. How an heart pumps the blood to each and every part of the body, like that the communication spreads the information to each and every corner of the enterprise. Therefore, communication is very, very helpful to exchange the ideas, to give the instructions, to give the suggestions or guidelines to the employees, and to send the report to higher level officials. Therefore, the communication is one of the major element in directing. So here, before going to know the exact meaning of the word communication, so just we must know from where the word communication has been derived. The English word communication is derived from Latin word communis. So Latin word communis, which makes common. So here the English word communication is derived from a Latin word communis, which means common, where the English word derived from Latin word communis. In Latin language, communis means common. So where, what exactly the communication is? So it is an English word. So then what the communication exactly stands for? Can anybody? What is communication? Just do revise, do remember. So here, communication means it is an systematic process of exchange of ideas, facts, opinions, emotions, views, thoughts from one person to another person. So here there is an person A and person B. So they want to convey the opinion, or they want to exchange an ideas between these two persons. Means what is required? The communication is required. So with the help of communication, they are going to exchange ideas between them, and they will going to complete the activity which is given by the superior. So therefore, in simple words, communication means it is an process of exchanging of ideas, facts, opinions, emotions, views, thoughts from one person to another person. That is called communication. So therefore, without communication, it becomes very, very difficult to the manager and to the entire human resource in the organization for getting of instructions and suggestions. Say for example, I am teaching about some concept, means I must use the language by using the language and by using certain medium, I must convey the information to you. Either it may be directly or indirectly. So if I give the information directly to you, means face to face, means that comes in face to face communication. When I am giving information through other medias, means like through digital form, means that comes under non-personal, means we are using the indirect communication tools for convey of informations. Hence, once again I am repeating, the English word communication is derived from Latin word communis, which means common understanding, where communication exactly stands for it is a process of exchange of ideas, facts, opinions and emotions, views, thoughts from one person to another person. That is about the meaning of communication. So communication is also one of the main important element in the process of directing. Let's see what is the element of communication. It can be referred as the process of communication also. So mainly there are certain elements that are to be required for making effective communication. So if you want to say the communication is effective, means there are certain basic requirements, basic elements that are to be required. What are those elements and what are the series of stages to be followed in making the communication effective? So let's see what are the elements of communication. So the first element of communication, that is sender. Who is called sender? So here sender is a person who is conveying or who wants to give information to other person. They are called a sender. So is it clear? Sender is a person who is intending to communicate or who is intending to transfer the information to other person. They are called the sender. So the sender is a source of information. So because the sender have all the information, all the ideas, all the views and the thoughts, so he is conveying information to other person. So they called as the sender. Is it clear? Sender is a person who is intending to communicate or who is conveying information to other persons. He or she called as a sender. So sender act as a source of information. So the sender, he or she have all the information about a matter or about a subject. So they are going to send information to other persons. Therefore, sender is a basic requirement in communication. So after that comes, that is second, message. What is message? So what it contains? So here the message is nothing but subject matter of communication. What is message? Message is a subject matter of communication, that what information that you want to convey to other person. What do you want to talk? What do you want to exchange the information? What information that you want to convey to other person, that is important. So here the message stands for subject matter of communication. So that may be an idea, that may be a report, that may be an views, thoughts, opinions, whatever it may be. So what the sender wants to communicate, that is called subject matter. That subject matter comes in the message. What you want to convey, that is message. So once you decided the message, then next comes, that is encoding. So what is encoding? So here encoding means conversion or translation of idea into actions or symbols or pictures. So here what is encoding? Encoding means it is an process of conversion or translation of ideas, views, opinions or message into actions, symbols, pictures. See, for example, when we want to speak in silent area, so the area will be silent. So say for example library, so we need to maintain the silence in a library. So at the time you want to convey information to your friend, so that is very urgency. At the time how you will going to convey information? So like you are going to make actions, come here, go there, bring the pen, so bring the notes, so check the notes, like that you are making actions without using word of mouth. Those actions are called encoding or encoders. So all of you might have made, so when you are sitting in the library or when while running a class, you should not speak between the class. At that time, even if you want to convey any urgent information, so you are going to make certain symbols or certain actions. Give me a pen, so give me a notes, come here, go there, so stand, sit, stand. Like by making certain actions, we are converting our idea or our information into useful actions, symbols or pictures. That is a process called encoding. So the encoding is to be done by the sender. If I am conveying any information, so if I am telling that keep silence, I will not speak, just I'll show like this. So it's understood that you need to keep silence. So that is an activity of encoding. So after that comes, that is media. So here media means it is an element, so in which or through which the information is passed. So whether you are giving information through the letter or you are conveying information through the radio or you are conveying information through the television or you are conveying information through face-to-face communication, that is direct communication. So how you are conveying information, so that is also very important, right? So say for example, so if there is no lockdown, if there is no COVID, the regular classes will be continued. Based on that, face-to-face conversation or face-to-face learning process will be undertaken. Teaching and learning process will be undertaken. But because it is an COVID situation, we need to take care of our health. That's why we are conveying information through certain medias. Like, therefore, when you are conveying or transferring information, at that time you need to decide through which information is passed. So while selecting the media, it is to be comfortable for receiver and sender also. So if you are sending information through an internet or if you are sending information through a smartphone, or the information will be accessed only through the smartphone or Android phone. So if the receiver is not have the smartphone, means you cannot able to communicate properly. So like that, the media is very important element so in communication. So therefore, while conveying information, sender must choose the appropriate media in which the communication is to be conducted. Either that may be in through the form of letters or radio, television, or it may be in a face-to-face communication. Then after selecting the media, that comes decoding. So here encoding and decoding are interrelated. In encoding, what you are going to do? So in encoding, you are converting the information into useful symbols, pictures, etc. But in decoding, what happens means, in decoding, converting of symbols into useful information. So in decoding, we are like translating or we are converting encoded message into useful information. Say for example, I will not speak, just I'll make an action like this. What it indicates? You need to keep silence. So like that, in which symbol or in which action that I conveyed the information, that is to be translated or converted by the receiver. That is important. Decoding means converting of symbols into useful information. If I made like this symbol, it's understood that keep silence. If I did like this, means stand. If I made action like this, sit. So like that. That is an decoding process. So after decoding, the next element comes receiver. So here the sender and receiver are called two faces of an communication. So like how a coin have two face, like head and tail, like that communication also have two faces. One is sender, then next is receiver. I'm giving information, but there are no receivers, there are no viewers, means the communication is not effective. So therefore, receiver means, receiver is a person who is getting the information or who is receiving the matter which is being conveyed by the sender. That is called a receiver. So is it clear? Receiver means, receiver is a person who is getting or receiving the information which is conveyed by the sender. They are called a receiver. So after that comes, that is feedback. So here the feedback means it is an reaction or reply or response which is given by receiver to the sender. Always the feedback is to be given by receiver to the sender. So the receiver conveys regarding about whether the message is being delivered or received, and whether he understood the information which is being conveyed. Is it clear? Feedback is an reaction or reply or response which is given by receiver to the sender of information. So this is about the feedback. The next comes one of the main important element in communication, that is noise. So while teacher in a class, so they are going to use the word like don't make noise while running the class. So what is noise? What exactly it stands for? Noise means it is an obstructions or obstacles in the process of communication. So what is communication? Communication means conveying of information, but noise means obstructions in a communication, like disturbances in a communication process. Say for example, I am giving information over the telephone. So by making phone call, I am giving information to the receiver. But if I am not having good network, or if the receiver is not having a good network, means the communication will not be effective, because of there is a problem of issues of network. There is no proper availability of signals to receive a call or to hear the message which is being conveyed by the sender. So, and one more example I'll give. I have sent a message through encoding. By making an encoding, I am sending an information. If the receiver is not properly conveyed, at that time the communication will not be effective. Say for example, just I shown as like this symbol. So if you understood this symbol as keep silence, the receiver is going to keep silence. If the receiver does not perceive what exactly this action stands for, means the communication will not be effective. There is no use of communication. So when you are conveying information through the picture, symbol or actions, if the receiver is not perceived what exactly that action stands for means, that is, no matter the effectiveness of communication, it would be waste. Therefore, noise stands for obstructions in the process of communication. So it may be on the side of sender, or the noise may be on the side of receiver, or noise it may be in the choice of selecting media, or it may be in the process of encoding or decoding, however it may be. So this is all about the elements of communication or the process of communication. So like this, it is a common process for each and everyone in the process of communication. So just think over. So the communication must be effective means there must be a sender and there must be a receiver. Sender, so take an example of a class. I am giving information means I will be the sender. You are receiving the information means you would be the receiver. And I am deciding the message, or I am deciding the content of matter of communication, what I want to convey the information. So if the message is to be conveyed through symbols or signals, I will going to use the encoding and decoding process. Otherwise, I will go with selecting media and transferring of information. So this is all about the elements or process of communication. The next concept is importance of communication. So importance can also to be referred as benefits of communication. So it answer for a question that why the communication is required. Why the communication is required in business or at the working place? What are the benefits that we are going to get by using an element of communication? There are mainly 7 benefits that we are going to get with the help of an element of communication. Let's see what are those benefits. The first benefit is it act as a basis for coordination. So as you know about the meaning of coordination, so what is coordination? Just remember where you learned about coordination. You learned in the first chapter. Coordination means it is a process of combining or integrating or synchronizing the efforts of all the departments in the enterprise. By combining or by unification of efforts, you are ensuring the achievement of organizational goals with united manner. So if the coordination is to be effective, means you must use the element of communication. How? By conveying information, by giving guidelines, by taking the work report, by proper assignment of duties, by providing timely instructions to the employees, you are creating a positive attitude in the minds of superior and subordinates. Then all the people combined together, they are working for achieving the goals. Therefore, communication acts as a basis for coordination. Then second, it ensures smooth working of the enterprise. So here, through the help of communication, the clear working orders, clear working rules and regulations, and clear matter or informations of guidelines to be given to the subordinates. At that time, without having any confusions or if they have any doubts, immediately the doubts are being clarified, means there is no problem in disturbances of doing work. So by giving timely suggestions, instructions, guidelines to the employees, we are ensuring smooth working of an entire organizational activities. That is the second benefit. Then third comes, it acts as a basis for decision making. So already you know about the meaning of decision making. What it means, where you learned about this concept in planning chapter. Decision making means it is a process of choosing or selecting one best alternative to resolve the problem of an organization. There are so many methods or ways are available, among which is the best, you are choosing that way in achieving targets. Therefore, the basis for decision making. So the communication helps in getting proper information, exact information. By using those available datas, it helps in analyzing the problem, and by receiving the opinions or suggestions by all the members in company, they are going to choose the best solutions. Then fourth, it increases managerial efficiency. Again, the word efficiency. So with the help of communication, the managerial efficiency is to be ensured. Means there is no mistakes or there is no confusions to be done by an executives in the organization. By giving proper guidelines, timely monitoring of performance, timely providing of decisions and proper allocation of work, by all these means the work is to be performed efficiently, means completing the task without making any wastage, using the resources maximum and producing the goods at a least cost of production. That is efficiency. Then fifth, it promotes cooperation and industrial peace. So we, with the help of communication, we can create the better relationship with the subordinates, colleagues, superiors and subordinates, and we can maintain the industrial peace. So there is no conflicts to be arised between the organization or within the organization. By to be freely and frankly speaking of all the information to each and everyone, so we can ensure the peace in the organization. So that is the fifth benefit. Then sixth, establishes effective leadership. So leadership means it is a capability of an individual who influence followers or others. The person who is having good communication skills, they would become an leaders in the organization. That is also one of the basic quality of a leader. So if you have good communication skills, if you have an caliber to work in the organization, then you become a leader. So that is why the communication establishes effective leadership, and it encourages a person to become leader. Then last, it boosts morale and provides motivation. It encourages the person and it stimulates or inspires an employee to work much betterly for achieving organizational goals and objectives. Through the help of identification of needs of an employee by providing proper facilities to those employees, it motivates an employee, by that it encouraging them to work even more and more in the enterprise. So with the help of all these 7 points, we can explain the concept of importance of communication. So this is about today. What you learned? You learned about the elements or process of communication and also the concept of importance of communication. Thank you.